No offense to the LGBT community, not that I think I need to say no offense. First of all, God's spirit is not gay. It does not allow for gayness. That is part of why these LGBT Satanists who have all this money and their allies, the massive atheist movement in this nation, etc., is why they edit my videos to try to make it so I seem like them. It is fucking immature. It is sick, and no servant can be greater. Anyone who is playing stupid about it is serving them. One who's slack in his work is brother to one who destroys. Okay, they're serving the one who destroys. They're helping one who destroys. They're serving the same master that is a destroyer as one who destroys, etc. Pretty straightforward. Anyone who plays stupid about the gay agenda and white supremacy and the Jewish pardon and so on and so forth, they are like them. They are them. They are in their spirit. There's no way around that. So when we look at this picture of this priest or preacher I'm going to put on the screen, notice he has a kind of autistic, sort of gay, kind of Bill Gates-ish, sort of look, frat, Jew, gay, nerd. Okay, again, I don't care what race you are, okay? Certain people are more active than others in this. Everyone outside the divine order is doing the wrong thing. You get it. And most people understand these things. So when you look at his characteristics, is that guy a holy man? No. Is he in the spirit of righteousness? No. You think righteousness is being a geek when in their own language, right? The Western geeks put that being a nerd is being a foolish and contemptible person. Is your argument that the spirit of God, which gives you sound judgment, makes you foolish and contemptible? Is your argument that the spirit of God is using contrast and deceit to say, well, I am a very educated British person and that person is a nerd and I am in the spirit? Is that your argument? It's stupid. It's stupid. It's stupid. It's God Almighty. God is love, true love, not privileged bullshit, okay? Righteousness, justice. God is a warrior. Not a soldier, not a nerd, not a cop, a warrior. Not those guys who beat Rodney King. We're doing it for God. Not the LAPD, not the San Jose PD, not any law enforcement agency. They serve this world. Isaiah says that the nations are nothing to God. If you dedicate to your life to serve something that is nothing to God, and you put that before rallying to God's Son and obeying God through Him, have you not testified against yourself to the extreme? That's simple. And they lead their families by example. Okay, is my goal to just, you know, kick them while they're down? No. They made it so I have to clarify it by trying to make it so I seem gay. They changed my voice in the video and so on and so forth, trying to make it sound like I have a gay speech pattern, lisps, mannerisms. They have technology where they don't need my videos to do these things. They have the technology to put an image on the screen that looks like me, change the mannerisms, change the voice. So know the truth, okay? Obviously, there's no financial incentive. There's no sexual incentive for me to do these things. There's nothing in this for me. What I'm doing is coming out of Babylon's system, knowing that people are almost certainly not gonna follow me. If there was, it'd probably be a small group of people at best, okay? It's not exactly for fame and fortune or sex. Clear cut. Obviously, I don't work for the deep state or anything like that, because I'm telling you things that aren't in their best interest. You know by my deeds, by my argument, by my fruits, okay? Wisdom as the fruit of the righteous, the fruit of the godly, the fruit of God. So again, the guy on the screen, okay? Some people might, now I'm not necessarily saying he is or isn't, and for the purpose of this video, they might describe him as Ebert, Hubert, Dexter. They might call him funny names in his own culture. You think in Igbo's own culture that they would call the top martial artist, the Igbo King of Kings, okay, these names? No, not until the West came in and said, we want you to do things in a way that elevates nerd traits like us, okay? They wouldn't dream of it. But in their own culture, historically, they're just an arrogant, pompous King George-like type dog. They're a greedy, sniveling worm. They're a foolish and contemptible person. Clear cut. Clear cut. They have no viable counterargument. Their nerd, preacher, and priest, and minister spirit is not the spirit of God. It's the spirit of conformist geek without the heart to obey God through me.